next problem is in the inventory system, the next problem is news dealers problem. Okay, this is also called as news problem, newspaper problem also. Okay, it is a news dealers problem. Sometimes people will call, sometimes people will call it as newspaper problem. Okay, it's a classical inventory problem which will concerns the purchase and sales of a newspaper. Okay, we do concern about the purchase and sale of the newspaper. This is a inventory problem. Okay, take down the problem. The newsstand buys the paper for 33 cents. The newsstand buys the paper for 33 cents and sells them for 50 cents each. Newspapers not sold at the end of the day are sold as scrap. Are sold as scraps for 5 cents each. 5 cents each. Next, newspaper can be purchased in bundles of 10. Newspaper can be purchased in bundles of 10. Thus, newsstand can buy 50, 60, 70, and so on. There are three types of days. That is good, fair, poor. Good, fair, poor. They have the probabilities 0.35, 0.45, 0.20. Distribution of newspapers demanded on each of these days is given below. Take down this table. Okay, demand is like this. That is 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Okay, next, probability of distribution for the good day, fair day, and poor day is given like this. Good day probability is 0.03, 0.05, 0.15, 0.20, 0.35, 0.15, 0.07. That is good day's probability distribution. And fair day's probability distribution also is given here. That is 0.10, 0.18, 0.40, 0.20, 0.08, 0.04, and 0.00. The probability distribution for fair day. Next day is average day or poor day, we call it as. Okay, for poor day, the probability distribution is given as 0.44, 0.22, 0.16, 0.12, 0.06, 0.00, 0.00. These are the probability distribution for poor day. Okay. Now we need to calculate the demand for 10 days. Okay, that means we need to construct a simulation table for 10 days. Calculate the demand for 10 days and record the profits from the sales each day. Record the profits from sales each day. And find the optimal number of papers the newsstand should purchase. Find the optimal number of papers the newsstand should purchase. Okay. And consider the random digits as given below. Okay. Here the random digits for the type of the news days is 58, 17, 21, 45, 43, 36, 27, 73, 86, and 19. These are the random digit for type of the news day. Okay. Next, random digit for the demand. Random digit for the demand is 93, 63, 31, 19, 91, 75, 84, 37, 23, 02. This is the random digit for demand. Okay. Assume the newsstand buys 70 newspapers each day. Okay. The news seller is buying every day 70 newspapers. Okay. And demand is like this. We need to construct a simulation table. Okay. And we need to record the profit from the sales of each day. We need to record it in the simulation table. Okay. The first one we have in the question is given that there are three types of days and their probabilities are given in the question. Okay. Understand the question first. The newsstand buys the papers for 33 cents. Okay. Newspaper seller will buy the newspaper for 33 cents and he will sell the newspaper for 50 cents each. Okay. And if it not get sold, whatever the papers he had purchased in the morning, at the end of the day, he will sell that remaining newspaper for the scrap for 5 cents each newspaper. Okay. And the newspaper purchased in the form of bundles of 10 bundles only. Like that, 10 bundles, he will buy 7 bundles. That's what 70 newspapers per day he is buying. Like that, it is given in the question. Okay. So, in the question they have given, the days are of three types. Good day, fair day, poor day. And its probabilities also is given. That is 0.35, 0.45, 0.20. Okay. Here, the depends on the demand. We can say it is a poor day, good day or poor fair day. Okay. We'll construct first distribution table for the type of the news day. Okay. The type of the news day is good, fair, and poor. Poor or average. Okay. These are the three types of days they have given in the problem. And the probability for the days also is given in the problem. That is 0.35, 0.45, 0.20. We'll copy from the question. These two things. Type of the days and probabilities. Now we have the probability. We know how to construct the cumulative probability. Okay. For always, the first one's cumulative probability is the same one. Okay. The probability will be the same as the cumulative probability also. Okay. So for next one, the cumulative probability we calculate by sum of the previous cumulative probability and present one's probability, we'll get the present one's cumulative probability. That is the addition of 0.35 plus 0.45, we will get 0.80. This is the cumulative probability for fair day. Okay. For next day, cumulative probability, we calculate the sum of previous day's cumulative probability plus the present day's probability. Previous day's cumulative probability was how much? It is 0.80. 0.80 plus 0.20, we will get 1.00. Okay, this is the cumulative probability for poor day. Now we need to assign the random digit assignment. Okay, while assigning the random digit assignment, first we need to decide whether it is 2-digit random digit or 3-digit random digit. That is depends on the type of random digits they have given in the question. Here in the problem, they have given the random digits are of 2 digits. So we need to consider 2-digit random digit only. Okay. So for the type of day, the random digit they have given is 2 digits. Okay. So we need to assign the 2-digit random digit. always the random digit assignment will start from 1. So 1 to it is 35. How the 35 got? That is from cumulative probability. Okay, the cumulative probability is 0.35 for the good day. So the random digit we have assigned is 1 to 35. Okay, next random digit will start from 36. 36 to its cumulative probability is 0.80. So its random digit is 36 to 80. Okay, next day will random digit will start from 81. 81 to its cumulative probability is 1.00. But we should not take it as 100 here. This is the random digits are given as 00. So the range of this random digit should be 81 to 99 and 00. It comes within this range. Okay. 81 to 00. We need to write it. Understood, right? Writing the cumulative probability. Okay. In this way, we do write the cumulative probability. We will calculate the cumulative probability and we do assign the random digit for the three different days we have constructed a table. Okay. Now we'll see random digit assignment for the newspaper demand. Okay. Here in the question, they have given the demand for the each day. Okay, that is in question they have given the demands and probability for the each different day they have given in the question. Copy the demands as it is. You can see here. Demand are 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. And these are the good days probability. This is the fair day probability. This is the poor day probability. That you copy to the problem. Okay. Here, the demand is 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Okay. And the good days probability is given in the question is 0.03, 0.05, 0.15, 0.20, 0.35, 0.15, 0.07. Okay. This is the probability. If you know the probability, we know how to calculate the cumulative probability. The first one, the cumulative probability will be same as the probability. So that is, its cumulative probability is 0.03. Okay. For the second one, we calculate the cumulative probability. That is by adding the previous cumulative probability plus the present one's probability. Previous one's the cumulative probability is 0.03 plus the present one's probability is 0.05. 0.03 plus 0.05, we will get 0.08. Okay. For next one, it is the previous cumulative probability is 0.08. That we'll add with the present probability. That is, we'll get 0.15. 0.08 plus 0.15, we will get 0.23. 0.23 plus 0.20, we will get 0.43. 0.43 plus 0.35, we will get 0.78. Okay. 0.78 plus 0.15, we will get 0.93. Okay. 0.93 plus 0.07, we will get 1.00. This is the cumulative probability calculation for the good day. Now we need to assign the random digit for the good day. Okay. Always here, before assigning the random digit, we need to check whether the random digit is 2-digit random digit or 3-digit random digit. Here in the problem, for the demand, random digit for the demand, they have given 2-digit probability. So we should consider 2-digit probability only. We need to assign 2-digit probability only. Okay, so here the first one, the random digit assignment always starts from 1. 1 to, and where it will end, that depends on cumulative probability. Cumulative probability is given as 0.03. So it is 1, 2, 3 is the random digit for the first day. Okay, next one, the random digit is, will start from the 4 and its cumulative probability is 0.08. It is 4 to 8. Okay, that is the random digit assignment for the next one. For the next one, the random digit assignment will start from 9 because the previous one is ended at 8. So next one's the random digit will start from 9 and 9 to it is 23 because its cumulative probability is 0.23. Okay, for the next one, the random digit assignment will start from 24 and its cumulative probability is 0.43. So it is 24 to 43. Okay, next one's random digit assignment will start from 44 and its cumulative probability is 0.78. So it is 44 to 78 is the random digit assignment for this. Next one's random digit assignment will start from the 79 and its cumulative probability is 0.93. So it is 79 to 93. Okay, next one's random digit assignment will start from the 94. And its cumulative probability is 1.00. But we should not take as 100. 100 if you take, the random digit will become 3-digit random digit. So the cumulative probability we need to, the random digit assignment, we should take it from 94 to 00. That means if this range includes the 94 to 99 numbers, plus 00 also will be included in this range. Okay, 94 to 00. Next, the fair days probabilities also given in the question. The probabilities for the fair days given in the question is 0.10, 0.18, 0.40, 0.20, 0.08, 0.04, and 0.00. This is the probability given in the question. Now we need to calculate the cumulative probability. For always, while calculating the cumulative probability, the first one's cumulative probability will be same as the probability. Here the probability is given as 0.10. Its cumulative probability will write it as 0.10. So next one's cumulative probability we calculate by adding the previous one's cumulative probability with the present one's probability. Will get the cumulative probability for the present one. That is, the previous cumulative probability was 0.10. So 0.10. The present probability is 0.18. 0.10 plus 0.18, we will get 0.28. Okay. Like that, same way we need to calculate other cumulative probability also. 0.28 plus 0.40 will get 0.68. 0.68 plus 0.20 we will get 0.88. Okay, next we'll calculate 0.88 plus 0.08 we will get 0.96. Right, 0.96 plus 0.04, we will get 1.00. Okay, so once we got the 1.00, that is the final cumulative probability. So we'll stop here. Okay, this will just stop finding the cumulative probability. Anyway, the probability is also given as 0.00 for the next one. Okay, and now we need to assign the random digit for this fair day. Okay, so always the random digit will, first we need to decide whether the random digit is 2-digit or 3-digit. Demand it is given in the question, the random digit is 2-digit random digit. So we need to take 2-digit random digit. Always the random digit will start from 1. So 1 to its cumulative probability is 0.10. So it is random digit will assign as 1 to 10. Okay, next one, random digit assignment will start from the 11 and its cumulative probability is 0.28. So the random digit assignment is 11 to 28. Okay, for next one, random digit assignment will start from 29. Okay, and its cumulative probability is 0.68. So 29 to 68 is the random digit assignment. Okay, for the next one, the random digit assignment will start from 69, and its cumulative probability is 0.88. So the random digit assignment is 69 to 88. Okay, for the next one, the random digit will start from 89. Its cumulative probability is 96. So 89 to 96 is the random digit we will assign. For the next one, the random digit assignment will start from 97. Its cumulative probability is 1.00. So the random digit assignment will write it as 97 to 00. Okay. This 00 will 97 to 00 will include the range of 97 to 99 and 0. Okay. For the next one, we doesn't need to assign any random digit because there is no cumulative probability. And if you start assigning the random digit, it should be again from the 1 to. Okay. So we'll stop assigning the random digit here. Next one, for the poor day or average day, the probability is given in the question is 0.44, 0.22, 0.16, 0.12, 0.06, 0.00, 0.00. This copy it from the question problem. This is given in the question. Okay. Now we need to calculate the cumulative probability. Always the first one's cumulative probability will be same as probability. So it is 0.44 is the probability. So the cumulative probability also it is 0.44. Okay. For the next one, the cumulative probability we calculate from the, it is sum of the previous one's cumulative probability and present one's probability. That is, the previous one's cumulative probability is 0.44 plus the present one's probability is 0.22. Okay, we will get 0.66. 0.44 plus 0.22, we will get 0.66. Okay, next cumulative probability, we'll add the previous cumulative probability plus the present probability. That is 0.66 plus 0.16, we will get 0.82. Okay, 0.82 plus 0.12, we will get 0.94. Okay, 0.94 plus 0.06, we will get 1.00. Okay, and next probabilities are given in the question as 00. So we don't calculate the cumulative probability. Okay, now we need to assign the random digit for this. While assigning the random digit, first we need to decide whether it is 2-digit random digit or 3-digit random digit. Here for the demand, they have given in the question the random digit is 2-digit random digit. So we need to assign the 2-digit random digit only here. Okay. So always the random digit assignment will start from the 1. So it is 1 to, its cumulative probability is 0.44. So it is 1 to 44 is the random digit we'll assign for the first one. So next one random digit assignment will start from 45. 45 to its cumulative probability is 0.66. Okay, 45 to 66 we'll assign the random digit assignment. Okay, for the next one, the cumulative probability is given as 82. Okay, so its next one's random digit assignment will start from the 67 to 82 because its cumulative probability is 82, 67 to 82. Next one's the random digit assignment will start from 83 to 94 because of its cumulative probability is given as 0.94. It is 83 to 94. Next one random digit assignment will start from 95 and its cumulative probability is given as 1.00. So it's we can't take the 3-digit random digit assignment. So we'll assign the random digit as 95 to 00. That includes 95 to 99 values and 00 also will be included in this range itself. Okay, this way we'll assign the random digit for good day, fair day, and average day for the demand. Okay, now we'll construct a table for a random digit. By using the random digit, we'll identify whether the day is good day or fair day, and that day what is the demand, we need to find it now. Okay, here they have asked us to construct a simulation table for 10 days. Okay, so the days I have written as days numbers as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 days. And random digits for the type of the day is given in the problem, that is 58, 17, 21, 45, 43, 36, 27, 73, 86, 19. It is given in the question, you can see here. Okay, it is given in the question. It is random digit for the type of the news day is given as 58, 17, 21, 45, 43, 36, 27, 73, 86, and 19. Okay, that we are writing as it is in the table. For these days, we need to find it. If it is the 58 is the random digit, what is the day we need to find it? For that, we need to go for first table where we have assigned the random digit for the type of the day. Okay. Here, the random digit for the day is 58 is given in the question. We need to find what is the type of the day. Okay. 58, where it will come in this? 58 comes in between the range of 36 to 80. The day is fair day. So we'll write fair day there. Okay, we'll write fair day, F. F stands for fair day. Next is 17. 17, where it, which day will come? 17 will comes in the first table in between the range of 1 to 35. 17 is good day. So we'll write good day. Okay. Next one, 21. Random digit 21 will comes in the table in between the range of 1 to 35. That is also a good day. So we'll write good day there. Okay. We'll write good day. Next, random digit is 45. 45 comes in this table in between the range of 36 to 80. Okay, 36 to 80, the day is fair day. So we'll write fair day. Okay, it is fair day we are writing here. Okay, next random digit is 43. 43, where, in which range it comes in the table? 43 comes in the range of 36 to 80. Okay, 36 to 80, the day is fair. So we'll write the day as fair here. Okay, the day is fair. Next random digit is 27. Okay, 27, where it comes? 27 comes in the range of 1 to 35. 1 to 35, the day is good. So we'll write good for the random digit 27. Okay, for the random digit 27, we will write day as good. Next random digit is 73. 73, where it will come in this range, in this table? 73 comes in between the 36 to 80 range. The day is fair. So we'll write fair for the random digit 73. Okay, for this we will write fair. Okay, next random digit is given as 86. Okay, 86 in this table, 86 comes in between the 81 to 00. That day is what type of day it is? It is a average day or poor day. So we'll write it as poor day here. Okay, it is poor day. 86 is poor day. Next random digit is 19. Where the 19 comes in this table? 19 comes in this table in between 1 to 35 random digit. Okay, so that is type of the day is good day. So we'll write for 19 random digit as good day. So mentioned as G here. Okay, next random digit for the demand is given in the question. That is random digit for the demand is given in the problem. That is here you can see. Yeah, random digit for demand is given in the question. That is 93, 63, 31, 19, 91, 75, 84, 37, 23, 2. This is the random digit for demand. Okay. Do concentrate here. We'll write the demands as given in the question. That is 93, 63, 31, 19, 91, 75, 84, 37, 23 and 2. Okay. These are the random digit for demand. Okay. We have written here in this table. Next, we need to find the demand depends on the random digit for the demand. Okay, 93 is the random digit and day is fair day. In this table, fair day, where the 93 comes, we need to find it. Fair day, where the 93 comes, 93 comes in the range of 89 to 96. Okay, that day, what is the demand? The day's demand is 80. We'll write 80 there. Okay, we'll write 80 here. Okay, next random digit for demand is 63 and the type of the day is good day. So we need to check in the good day for this random digit. Okay, in good day, where this 63 comes in, we need to check it. In good day, okay, this is the good day. Where 63 comes here, 63 comes in between the range of 44 to 78. That day's demand is what? It is 80. So we'll write 80 there. Okay, for 63, the demand is 80. We will write. Okay, next random digit is 31. Okay, 31 and day is good day. In table, in this good day, where the 31 will come, 31 comes in between the range of 24 to 43. For this 24 to 43 random digit assignment, the demand is that day is 70. We will write 70 there. Okay, 31 random digit, good day, it is, demand is 70. Okay, next random digit is 19. For 19, day type of the day is fair day. In fair day, where 19 comes, we need to check. Okay, in fair day, where 19 comes in between the range of 11 to 28. Okay, 11 to 28 range, 19 comes. In this 11 to 28 range, the demand is 50. We'll write 50 for the random digit 19. Okay, it is 50. We'll write 50 here. Understood? Next random digit is 91. Okay, for the 91 and day is, type of the day is fair day. In fair day, where 91 will come, we need to check in the fair day. In fair day, where 91 comes. 91 comes in the range of 89 to 96. That day's demand is what? Demand is 80. So we'll write 80 there. Okay. For 91 random digit, the demand is 80. Next random digit is 75. The type of the day is fair day. So we need to check in the fair day for 75 random digit. In fair day, random digit 75 will comes in between the range of 69 to 88, right? 69 to 88 range, the 75 will come. 69 to 88 range, what is the demand? The day's demand is 70. So we'll write 70 for random digit 75. Okay, for random digit 75, we'll write 70. Next random digit is 84, and the type of the day is good day. Okay. We need to check for the, in the good day, we need to check the where 84 comes. 84 comes in the range of 79 to 93. Okay, 79 to 93. What is the demand? Demand is 90. So we'll write 90 for the random digit 84. Okay, we'll write 90. Next random digit is 37. And the day type of the day is what? It is a fair day. So we need to check 37 in the fair day. In fair day, where 37 will come? 37 will come in the range of 29 to 68. That day's demand is how much? Demand is 60. So we'll write 60 for the random digit 37. Okay, we'll write 60 here. Next random digit is what? It is 23. 23 and type of the day is poor day. So we need to check for 23 in the poor day. Poor day or average day it is. 23, we need to check it in this poor day. Poor day 23 will comes in the range of 1 to 44. So that day's demand is what? It is 40 is the that day's demand. So we'll write 40 for the random digit 23. Okay. Next random digit is 2. And type of the day is good day. In good day, we need to check for random digit 2. In good day, the random digit 2 will come in between the range of 1 to 3. That day's demand is 40. So we'll write 40 for the day, 40 for the random digit for the demand 2 is 40. We will write 40 for the random digit 2. Okay. In this way, we will construct the days and random digit for the type of the day is given. By using this random digit for the type of the day, we'll find the type of the days. And by using the random digit for the demand and type of the day, we find the that random digit for that random digit the, for that type of the day, we find the demand. Okay, we'll see how to construct simulation table, and later we'll see how to calculate the final profit. Okay, this is the formula to calculate the final profit. We'll discuss this after completion of simulation table. Yeah, the simulation table will consist of these columns like days, type of news day, and what is the demand for the day. We need to calculate the revenue from the sales, lost profit from the sales, okay, lost profit from the excess demand, and salvage from the sales of scrap, and daily profit we need to calculate here. Okay, because why we are calculating this? Because to find the final profit. Profit can be calculated by using this formula. Like profit is equal to revenue from the sales minus cost of newspapers minus loss of profit from the excess demand plus salvage from the sale of the scrap papers. Using this formula, we will find the final profit of the newspaper. Okay, so for that we are having these columns in this table. Okay, days we need to write in the days column. How many days they have asked in the question to simulate? In question they have asked us to simulate for 10 days. So we'll write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 10 days we'll write it first. Okay, after writing this, next column we have type of the news days. Type of the news day we have calculated in this table number 3. Okay, by using the random digit which is given in the question. Okay, type of the day. Day 1 is fair day. Day 2 is good day. Day 3 is good day. Day 4 is fair day. Day 5 is fair day. Day 6 is fair day. Day 7 is good day. Day 8 is fair day. Day 9 is poor day. Day 10 is good day. So these day type of the days with respect to day, we will write it in the table. Okay. First day is fair day. Second day is good day. Third day is good day. Fourth day is fair day. Fifth day is fair day. Sixth day is fair day. Seventh day is good day. Eighth day is again fair day. Ninth day is poor day. Tenth day is good day. And we have calculated the demand also for each day's demand also we calculated in the table number 3. Okay. Here we have calculated the demand by using the random digit and by using the type of the day we have calculated the demand for that particular day. Okay. Day 1 demand is 80. Day 2 demand is 80. Day 3 demand is 70. Day 4 demand is 50. Day 5 demand is 80. Day 6 demand is 70. Day 7 demand is 90, day 8 demand is 60, day 9 demand is 40, day 10 demand is 40. Okay, why the demand changes day by day? Usually in newspapers, the people will read on weekends more. Weekends newspaper sales will be more. Okay, Saturday, Sunday newspapers will get sale more than the regular days. Regular days depends on the day. The paper sales will be okay. Demand will be changing depends on the day. Okay, you can see the day 1 is 80. We write these demands from the table number 3. Day 1 is 80, day 2 80, day 3 70, day 4 50, day 5 80, day 6 70, day 7 90, day 8 60, day 9 40. Day 10, 40. These are the demands. We will copy it. Okay. Next, revenue from the sales we need to calculate. Okay. Revenue from the sales to calculate, we have to do some calculation here. Okay. And in the question, they have given simulation is for 70 newspapers every day. Okay. And they told that 70 newspapers every day. And it is a fair day demand was 80. Okay. But every day the newspaper seller will buy only 70 newspapers every day. Okay. So demand was 80, but he has purchased only 70 newspapers. He will, whatever newspapers he will buy it, he will sell it for 50 cents. Okay. And if the day demand was less, that time whatever papers will be remaining, that papers he will sell it for scrap for the 50.5 cents. Okay, for 5 cents he will sell the newspaper for the scrap. Okay, here the day 1 is fair day. Fair day we have demand is 80. Okay, it is the first day is fair day, demand is 80. We need to calculate revenue from the sales. So we'll calculate here separately and we'll write the values here. Okay, day 1 is fair day and demand is 80. And number of available newspapers is how much? That is 70. That means every day the newspaper seller will buy 70 newspapers. This is constant. Okay, whether the demand is more or less, he is buying every day 70. Okay, and he will sell these 70 papers for 50 cents. Okay, sometimes all 70 papers will get sold, but some days the in 70 papers only 50 papers will get sold. Remaining 20 papers, he will end of the day he will sell it for scrap, okay, for 5 cents. Okay, here this day one is demand is 80 newspapers, but the newspaper seller is having 70 newspapers. Okay, the revenue from the sales is equal to 70 into selling cost of the newspaper. Selling cost of the newspaper is 50 cents. Okay, every day he will sell the paper for 50 cents. 70 into 50, that is 3500. Because we need to convert, it is in cents, so we need to convert into dollars. So that is $35. That day it is the revenue from the sales. Okay, next we need to calculate. Next column is lost profit from the excess demand. Okay, excess demand, because he has only 70 papers, that day demand was 80. If he might have had 10 more papers, he could have sell it for 50 cents, but he don't have 80 papers to sell. He had only 70 papers. 70 papers he sold it for 50 cents. Okay, now we need to calculate loss, how much loss from he excess demand. Lost profit from the how much he got loss, because even though there was a more demand, he don't have papers to sell. So the lost profit from the excess demand is demand minus total number of newspapers into lost profit cost. Okay, take down this formula. Lost profit from the excess demand equal to demand minus total number of newspapers into lost profit cost. Here demand is how much? The day is fair day, the demand is 80. Okay, 80, and total number of newspapers per day he buys is how much? Per day the newspaper seller will buy 70 newspapers. Demand is 80, 80 minus total number of newspapers per day his newspaper seller buys is 70 into lost profit cost. Lost profit cost is selling cost minus buying cost. Okay, the newspaper seller will sell the newspapers for 50 cents each. Okay, but he will buy the newspaper for 30 cents each. 33 cents he will buy the newspapers. For 70 newspapers every day he will buy for 33 cents each paper. Okay, that 70 papers he will sell it for 50 cents. Okay, so the lost profit cost will be calculated by the formula selling cost minus buying cost. Selling cost is 50 cents minus buying cost is 33 cents. So that is 50 minus 33, it is 17 cents. 80 minus 70, it is 10 newspapers. So 10 into 17, it is 170, it is in cents. If you convert into dollars, it is $1.7. Lost profit for excess demand is 1.7. So we'll write this 1.7 in the table, and the revenue from the sales is $35. That also we will write in the table. Okay, here in the table for the day one, we are writing it. Revenue from sales is $35 and lost profit from the excess demand is $1.7. Okay, next one, next column here we have is salvage from sales of a scrap. When we'll get some value here, salvage from sales of a scrap. If we have the 70 papers, that day demand was less than the 70. That time, the remaining papers, we will sell it for scrap. Okay, but here, the day one, the demand was more than the papers the new seller is having it. New seller had only 70 papers, but day one demand is 80 papers demand was there. Okay, so there will be no papers to sell it for scrap. Okay, this we'll keep it as empty. Next, we need to calculate the daily profit. Okay, daily profit to calculate, the formula is this. Take down this formula. Yeah, profit calculation formula is revenue from sales, profit equal to revenue from sales minus cost of newspapers minus cost of newspapers minus lost profit excess demand, lost profit from excess demand plus salvage from sales of scrap. Salvage from sales of scrap. Okay, here the revenue from the sales, how much we got for the day one? That is, we got revenue from the sales, we got $35. So $35 minus cost of newspapers. Cost of newspapers is nothing but how many papers he purchased with what cost. He total number of papers he purchased is 70 papers. Every day he newspapers seller will buy for 70 newspapers for 33 cents. Because 70 into 33 is the cost of newspapers. Excuse me. Okay. Minus lost profit for excess demand. Lost profit for excess demand is, you can see here. Here we have calculated it. That is $1.7. So that lost profit from the excess demand, we need to subtract it. Okay, that is $1.7 plus salvage from the sales of a scrap. Scrap, there is no scrap. So it is salvage from the sales of scrap is zero. So if you do 35 minus 70 into 33, we'll get 23.10. The convert, after converting into dollars, okay, 70 into 33, we will get the in cents, okay, that is 2310. We will get that, we convert into dollars, it is 23.10, okay, minus $1.7. So total we will get profit for the day is $10.2. $10.2 we will get the profit. Okay, that profit value we will write in the table. You can see here in day one, profit is 10.2. Okay, like this we need to calculate for the next day. Next day demand is what? Day two demand is also 80. So you will get the value same as this. You don't need to calculate it for, again for the day two. Day two's demand is 80. Because the every day the newspaper seller will buy 70 papers. Okay. So here the demand is same as the day one. So day two is also having the demand is same as day one. And how many newspapers the newspaper seller will buy? Like day one, day two also, he is buying only 70 newspapers. Okay. So the revenue from the sales we will get for the day two also is same. That is $35. And lost profit from the excess demand, he will get the same. That is $1.7. And there will be no salvage from the sales of the scrap. Because his demand is more than the papers he has. So he will not, there will be no papers to sell it for the scrap. Okay. Next, daily profit for the day two is same as the day one because the demand is same. So his profit also, that day's profit also will be same. That is $10.20. Okay. Next, you can see here day three. Day three, we need to, demand is 70. So for day three, we need to calculate the revenue from the sales. Okay, we'll see with the formula only, we'll calculate day two, day three also. Yeah, day three is good day and its demand is 70. Available newspapers is 70. Every day the newspaper seller will buy 70 newspapers. Okay. Now, the revenue from the sales we need to calculate. That is 70 into, for how much he will sell the paper? He will sell the papers for 50 cents. 70 into 50, we will get $35. $35 is the revenue from the sales. Okay, 3,500 cents we will get. If you convert that cents into dollars, we will get $35 here. Okay. Next, we need to calculate lost profit from excess demand. There is no excess demand here. Here the demand is 70 newspapers. The newspaper seller also is having 70 newspapers. So there is no lost profit from excess demand. We don't need to calculate here. Okay, available papers is equal to the demand. So that is 70 papers. Available is 70, demand also is 70. So the lost profit from the excess demand is zero. Next is salvage from the sales of the scrap. Because there is no extra papers to sell it for the scrap. There was only 70 papers. 70 papers demand was there. He had sold all 70 papers. Okay. So there is no remaining papers to sell it for scrap. So the scrap is zero. Okay. These values we need to update to the table. Revenue from the sales is $35. We will write it here. Yeah. Revenue from sales is $35. There is no loss profit from the excess demand. So we will not write anything. There is no papers to sell it for the scrap. So this also will keep it empty. Now we need to calculate the daily profit. Daily profit to calculate, we know the formula. Substitute the values in the formula, we will get the daily profit. Okay. The formula for the calculation of the daily profit is this. Like revenue from the sales minus total cost of the newspaper minus lost profit from the excess demand minus salvage from the scrap. Okay, revenue from the sales is $35. Now, cost for the papers is, cost of the newspapers is 70 papers. The new seller purchased it for 33 cents. 70 into 33, 2,310 cents. If you convert that into dollars, it is $23.10. Okay, and last profit from the excess demand is zero. Sales. Salvage from the sales of the scrap also is zero. The value we will get is 35 minus 23.10. We will get $11.90 as profit for the day three. That we'll update in the table. Okay. Day three, it is 11.90 is the profit. Okay. Next, day four. Day four is fair day. Fair day, and the demand for the day is 50 newspapers. Okay. Now we'll see how to calculate for day four. Demand is only 50, but the newspaper seller is having 70 papers. Okay. So he can sell the papers only 50. Only 50 papers demand is there. He can sell the papers only 50. Okay. Revenue from the sales is equal to 50 into 50 cents. That means only he can sell 50 newspapers because demand is 50. Into how much cost he will sell the newspaper? He will sell it for 50 cents each paper. We will get 2,500 cents. That if you convert into dollar, it is $25 we will get. Next, last profit from the excess demand. Here there is no excess demand only. Papers itself, available papers are 70. Demand is only 50. Okay, demand is less than the available papers. So here there is no last profit from the excess demand. There is no excess demand, so it is zero. Next is number of newspapers for the scrap. Okay, how many papers he had sold it for the scrap? That is 70 papers was available. Demand was only 50. 70 minus 50, it is 20 papers. 20 papers are available for the scrap. Okay, at the end of the day, he will sell these 20 papers for the cost of 5 cents. That will gives us the slavage cost. Okay, slavage from the sales of the scrap we will get from this. That is salvage from the sales of the scrap. Sales of the scrap is 20 into 5 cents. We will get 100 cents. Okay, that if we convert into dollars, we will get $1. For $1, he is selling 20 papers at the end of the day, remaining papers. Okay, these values will update into the table. Revenue from the sales is $25, and salvage from the sales of the scrap is $1. That will update to the table. Yeah, here revenue from the sales is $25, and there is no excess demand that day. Demand is less than the available papers, so it is empty. Next, salvage from the sales of the scrap, we got it $1. Okay, that we'll update in this table. Now we need to find the daily profit by using the same formula. That is revenue from the sales minus cost of the newspaper minus lost profit from the excess demand. Okay. Yeah. Here, revenue from the sales, that is $25 minus cost of the newspaper, that is 70 into 33. Cents minus lost profit from the excess demand. Excess demand is loss. So we are subtracting from the profit. Next, salvage from the sales of the scrap. That is some income. So we will add that to the profit. So it is plus slavage from the sales of a scrap. That we got $1. That we'll write it here. 25 minus 23.10 plus 1, we will get $2.9. $2.9 is the profit for day 4. That we'll update in the day 4 table. Okay, 2.90 is the profit for the day 4. Next, you see day 5 is fair day. Okay, that day's demand is how much? Demand is 80. 80 demand we have already calculated, because that every day the newspaper seller will buys the newspaper is constant. That is, every day he will buy 70 newspapers. So we doesn't need to do any calculations here. Copy the values from this, our day 1 or day 2. Both are same. So demand is same for day 1, day 2, and day 5. So the revenue from the sales also will be same. That is $35. And excess demand from the lost profit from the excess demand is $1.7. There is no papers to sell it for the scrap. So that is empty. The profit from the profit of that day 5 is 10.20. So we'll copy it from the day 1, all the values. Okay, next you see the fair 6th day is fair day. What is the demand for 6th day? 6th day's demand is 70. We have already calculated if the demand is 70. Okay, that is day 3. So the copy the day 3 values as it is for the day 6. That is 7. That is revenue is $35. There is no loss from the excess demand. There is no scrap of papers. And profit is 11.90. We'll write it 11.90 from the day 3. Understood, right? Next is day 7 is good day, and its demand is 90. Okay, we haven't calculated the demand is 90 yet. So we need to calculate it what is the profit for the if the demand is 90? Yeah, if demand is 90, available newspapers are 70. Revenue from the sales is 70 into how many, how much he is, what is the selling cost? 70 papers into he, available papers are only 70. 70 into 50 cents he is selling it. He will get the 3,500 cents. That if you convert into dollars, it is $35. Last profit from the excess demand. Here the demand is 90 newspapers, but the available newspapers are 70. So 90 minus 70, it is 20 newspapers into cost for the papers. That is selling cost minus buying cost. That is 50 is the selling cost. He purchased newspaper, seller purchased the newspaper for 33 cents. So 50 minus 33, it is 17 cents. So 20 into 17 cents, we will get 340 cents. If you convert that into dollars, we'll get $3.4. 3.4 is the last profit from the excess demand. Salvage from the sales of scrap is zero because there is no here. Newspapers are available, newspapers are 70, demand is more than that. Okay, whatever papers he is having, all the papers got sold. So there is no papers for scrap. Next, we need to calculate profit for that day. Profit is revenue from the sales minus cost of the paper. That is 70 into 33 cents. He will be buying it. Okay, 70 newspapers purchased it for 33 cents. That minus lost profit from the excess demand, that we have got $3.40, plus salvage from the sales of the scrap, that is zero. So we will get the profit for day 7 is $8.50. That we will update here in this table. Okay, we will update in this table. It is 8.50 is the profit for the day, and we'll update the revenue is $35, and loss from the excess demand is $3.40. Next day is fair day, and it is demand is 60. Okay, for 60 demand we haven't calculated, so we will calculate now for the demand is 60. If demand is 60, what is the revenue from the sales? So he newspaper person, every day he will buy 70 newspapers, but that day is only demand is 60. So he can sell the newspapers, 60 newspapers, only he can sell 60 newspapers for the 50 cents. Okay, he will get revenue from the sales profit is $30. Okay. Lost profit from the excess demand, there is no demand. Available papers are 70, demand is less than that. So lost profit from the excess demand is zero. Number of newspapers sold it for the scrap, that is 70 is the available newspapers, minus demand is 60. So 70 minus 60, 10 newspapers we will be selling it for scrap with the cost 10 into 5 cents. Okay, with 5 cents each paper, for 5 cents he will sell it for the scrap at the end of the day. So profit from the salvage from the sales of the scrap is, he will get $0.50. Now we need to calculate the profit for the day, that is revenue from the sales minus cost of the paper, purchase cost of the paper, that is 70 into 33 cents minus lost profit from the excess demand plus salvage cost, that is $0.50. We will get $7.40 per day. That values we will update here in the table. Okay. Revenue is $30. There is no excess demand, and from the scrap sale we will get $0.5, and total profit of the day is 7.40. Okay. Next day is poor day, and demand is 40. We haven't calculated for demand is 40. Now we will calculate if the demand is 40, what is the revenue from the sales? Okay, demand is 40 means the every day the newspaper seller will buy 70 newspapers. Okay, but he can only sell 40 newspapers that day because demand is less. So he can sell 40 newspapers for 50 cents. He will get $20. 40 into 50. 2000 cents, that if we convert into dollars, $20 we will get. Then last profit from the excess demand is less than the available newspapers, so the last profit is zero. And number of newspapers sold it for the scrap is, total number of available newspapers are 70 minus demand is 40. 70 minus 40 is 30. Okay, so slave wage cost is 30 papers. The newspaper seller is selling it for 5 cents at the end of the day, he will get $1.5. Okay, now profit is will be calculated by using the formula. Revenue from the sales, that is $20, minus cost for the newspapers, that is 70 newspapers, he will purchase it for the 33 cents, minus lost profit from the excess demand, that is zero, and salvage cost for selling for the scrap, that is $1.5. We will get 20 minus 23.10 plus 1.5. We will get minus $1.60. That day is loss. Okay, it is in negative. So that values we will update here. Okay. 20 is the revenue from the sales, no excess demand, so excess demand is empty, and from the scrap he will get $1.5. total profit for the day is minus 1.60. okay, next day 10. Day 10 is good day, and here that day demand is $40. 40 is the demand, 40 newspapers are the demand, so the same as day 9. So copy the values, same values from the day 9. Okay, now we'll find total profit. Total profit, if we'll add all these profit, we will get the profit as $70. Okay, if we add all the revenue from the sales, we will get $305. Okay, all the loss of profit from the excess demand, if we'll add it, we will get 8.5. if we'll add salvage from the sales of scrap, we will get 4.5. Substitute these values in the profit formula, we will get total profit. Profit is equal to revenue from the sales minus cost of the newspapers minus loss of profit from the excess demand plus salvage from the sales of the scrap papers. This is the formula to calculate the profit. Okay, what is the total revenue from the sales we have got? That is $305. Okay, total revenue. If we'll add these $35 plus $35 plus $35 plus $25 plus $35 plus $35 plus $35 plus $30 plus $20 plus $20, we will get $305. Okay, that is the revenue from the sales. That we'll write it there in the formula. We'll substitute in the formula. That is 305 minus cost of the newspapers. That is 70 papers. He will be buying it for 33 cents for how many days? 10 days. So 70 into 33 into 10. We will get $23.10. If you do the calculation, 73 into 33 cents, if you convert that into dollars, we will get $23.10. That into 10 days, we will get $231. that is the cost of newspapers for 10 days. The newspaper seller is spending it for buying the newspapers. Okay. Next, loss of profit from the excess demand. That we will get it here by adding the all the loss of profit from the excess demand. That is 1.7 plus 1.7 plus 1.7 plus 3.4. We will get 8.5 as the loss profit from the excess demand. That we will substitute here. That is minus 8.5 plus we need to add the salvage from the sales of the scrap. That we will get by adding the all the salvage from the sales of the scrap. That we got it $1, $0.5, $1.5, $1.5. Total we got $4.5. That we will add it to the formula. Okay, it is 305 minus 231 minus 8.5 plus $4.5. Total, if we do calculate it, the profit we will get $70. What is the profit we got it here? By if we'll add all the daily profits also, we should get $70. That is 10.20 plus 10.20 plus 11.90 plus 2.90 plus 10.20 plus 11.90, 8.50 plus 7.40 minus 1.60 minus 1.60. We will get $70. $70 is the total profit for the newspaper seller for selling the newspapers.